Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom, everybody. Tonight we celebrate Pride. On Shabbat, not to be confused with Pride Shabbat, because don't worry, we have that coming in the near future, God willing, when we can all gather, as we have for so many years now, because this community believes that our tent is huge. All you have to do is look around this Zoom room right now. It's so much bigger than this. It's so much bigger than any little rectangle can contain. This is our community. And tonight, as we think about pride and our place in the world in this very tumultuous moment, we kind of come in for a landing on this word, pride. We saw that beautiful poem by the poet who talked about this kind of very dynamic pride. And I want us to think tonight a little bit about pride, not just being that noun that we associate with LGBTQ pride, but actually a verb. If you were to enact this in the world, how do you show pride? How do you enable pride? How do you lift up pride? And tonight I'd like our question to actually be focused on one particular of so many issues and associated ideas with pride. And this is the one thing I'd like us to kind of hone in on and be our kavana, our intention for the evening, which is this. If pride is something that is dynamic and alive in the world, and I want to enact this as a verb, what is my place as an ally? What is my place as someone who supports this alive thing in the world? Whether you happen to be LGBTQ folks or not, what it means is we're here together to lift up this idea. And not only that, but to see that we, as a Jewish community, can embrace this and help it make its beautiful pride imprint on the world. There's so much that's happened recently, Supreme Court decisions that have made it possible for people not to be summarily dismissed from their work if they're LGBTQ folks. It has made it so that we are thinking at a deeper level than ever before, maybe than ever before. In this moment when we have race protests happening, in this moment where we're locked in our houses or we're daring to go out, this moment where we appreciate what safety means, we appreciate what otherization means, this is where we wrap our arms around and we're prideful. We are making pride alive. And so I would like you to think of yourself as that ally. What does it mean to be an ally? How do I lift up, support, and make it alive? And maybe you add just one or two words to the chat box that give us some idea of where you are. Where are you with pride? What are your associations with pride? Where do you see this taking us? We can go great places together. And as a Jewish community, All I can say is the very first thing that we made sure to do when we had a website was to make sure that we just had a very simple two messages. There is an all are welcome sign on our website, and right next to it is a rainbow flag. What does it mean to you? What is it, where does it take us? For a lot of people, it meant, oh, I think I can be at home here. And that's exactly what we want for everybody who comes through the doors or through the screens of Temple Israel. So we want to welcome you. Shabbat Shalom to everybody. Wave to your friends. Shabbat Shalom. And find your two candles. And let's light them now with Cantor Moses.
We bless and sing together. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav, v'tzivanu lehadlik ner, lehadlik ner, shel Shabbat. Shabbat Shalom.
Shalom. Amen. So, all these beautiful hues of our gorgeous community come together in this moment of Shabbat. I did choose this slide. We chose this slide for the occasion. I think we did a pretty good job. And now we welcome in Shabbat. A moment of breath, feeling safe and peaceful.
Lecha dodi likrat kala p'nei Shabbat nekavela. Lecha dodi likrat kala p'nei Shabbat nekavela. Lecha dodi dodi likrat kala p'nei Shabbat nekavela. Lecha dodi likrat kala Shabbat nekavela, shamor bezachor betiburecha, rishmiyanu ela meyuchad, Adonai echad, shemo echad, neshemo tiferet belitila. Lecha dodi dodi, adodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekavela. Adoni likra kana, beni Shabbat nekabela. Likra Shabbat lechu venelcha, ki begor echa beracha, meirosh mikedem nesucha, sof masei b'machshava tchila. Lecha dodi dodi, adoni likra kana. B'nei Shabbat nekavela, lecha dodi likrat kala. B'nei Shabbat nekavela, itoreri, itoreri, kiva ore, kubi uri, 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 shir daberi, kevod Adonai alaik nigla. Lecha dodi, dodi, Adodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi likrat kala, b'nei Shabbat nekabela. Bo'i v'shalom ateret bala, gam b'simcha u'b'tzola, toch emunei am segula. Bo'i chala, bo'i chala. Lecha dodi, dodi, adodi likrat kala. B'nei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi likrat kala. B'nei Shabbat nekabela.
this beautiful room full of people. We come to our attention and the words, you, be praised. All I can do, I can't bless you, but I can praise you. Far be it from me to bless something so vast and so awesome. But you I can thank, you I can praise.
Baruch Hu et Adonai ha-mevorach. Yai, lai, lai, lai,
to help us really focus on what is this blessing about coming into the evening all about. And then I chose this for the beautiful imagery and colors that you might, that might be, that it might emerge for you. Ma'ariv Aravim, an interpretation, you could read with me. A wind arrived from you one evening by the sea, caught a cloud and breathed it toward the sun, whose cooling warmth drew it pink and orange, purple, yellow, gold upon the strands and waves your sea wind had whipped white, caught the gold, laughed up the yellow, till waves and clouds, bright sea, bright sky, rode together, a tide of clouds come in, a tide gone out, to welcome evening sun, like mystics, surging towards Shabbat, its colors melting in the tide.
Umavir yom umevi laila umavdil ben yom uvein laila dunai tzvaot shemo el chai v'kayam tamid yimloch aleinu leolam vaed baruch ata Adonai Amariv Aravim Ki hem chayenu ve'orech yameinu Uvehem negei yomam v'alayla ve'avatcha Atasir mimenu le'olamim Baruch ata Adonai Ohev ama Israel, Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Kevod Machuto Leolam Vahed Ve'avtai Eit Adonai Elohecha V'chol levavcha V'chol nafshecha U'v'chol meodecha Ve'hayu Hadvarim Ha'ele Asher Anochi Mitzavcha Hayom Alevavecha Veshinatam levanecha v'dibarta bam v'shivtecha bebetecha uvlechtecha v'aderech u'shokbecha uvkumecha וקשרתם לאות על ידיך והיו לטטפות בין עיניך וכתבתם המזוזות ביתך ובישריך למען תזכרו ועשיתם את כל מצוותיי ויתם קדושים לאלוהיכם אני אדוני אלוהיכם אשר הוצאתי אתכם מארץ מצרים להיות לכם לאלוהים אני אדוני אלוהיכם אדוני אלוהיכם אמת
We're at the sea. We know that there is a vast sea in front of us that we have to cross. I feel like we can do it if we commit to doing it together. Read with me. How does the journey to freedom continue? Risking together what we never imagined possible on our own, we keep walking. The sea rises to our nostrils, then with a breath, the waters part. Following fire and cloud, we stumble through endless desert. At night, we build fragile shelters that sway in the wind. The water is too bitter to drink. Even manna sometimes tastes like sand. Some cry out for Egypt, longing to return to the known. How does our journey to freedom continue? We reawaken deep yearnings for history and song, for learning and connection. We glimpse new possibilities for our lives and our communities, for our families and our world. Some begin to plot change immediately. Others sit in the silence and absorb. For ours is a holy journey. We falter, but we will not turn back. Embracing the challenge of tradition, we clear new paths to the future. Pause right here because this is the moment where I usually ask you to just imagine that safest place that you possibly can, and I'd like you to invite everybody into it, that sukkah shalom, that shelter of peace. And on this special Shabbat where I'm asking you, what does it mean to be an ally, regardless of the issue, let's say, you know, this, it, I think that the phrase has become really known to us through the LGBTQ community, to be an ally. But there's so many issues that we need to be allies on. Allies play a vital role in building community and one that is inclusive to everyone. And whether you are a parent, a sibling, a friend, a leader, stepping up and speaking out as an ally on any issue tonight, being pride, we take pride in being the allies that we can be, supporting one another. And it has never been more important to be an ally in the world than maybe just this moment, to amplify our voices for justice and equality for all. In this week's Torah portion, there are two characters named Datan and Aviram, and two of them are major partners of Korach, who led a rebellion against Moses. and accused Moses of elevating himself over the rest of the people. And Moses does not do anything to really defend himself. The only thing that he says is he turns to God and says, "Not one donkey did I take from them." He's referring back to a time that he could have taken a donkey from the Hebrews on his return from Midian to Egypt. And he says, but I didn't do it. I could have been entitled to do so, but I did not do that. And that's his only response. The sages go on and they are so curious. Moses, you're not defensive. You're not defending yourself. You're not in the face of criticism. You're not really doing anything to say, but that wasn't me, that's not me. He is an example for us of what happens when criticism comes our way and we deflect it in a way because we might be secure. That's a natural reaction. When somebody lobs criticism our way, we might summarily dismiss somebody for their opinion on something that we've done. But what Moses does is he feels obligated. He feels obligated to consider the charges made against him of not being all the things that he says he is, this humble person. And when when that happens, we're also reminded of David, King David, who said something sort of similar and elaborates on this idea of, like, when self-criticism comes to you, when criticism is lobbed your way, David in the Psalm says, "When my enemies rise up against me, my ear will listen." My enemies, they rise up against me. How many harsh voices do we hear in the world today? We feel that our enemies are rising up against us. And in that moment of wanting to just be protected, you know, I don't want to build a shelter of peace. I just want to hide in a shelter of some place that's going to protect me from all of the hate or all of that you're not the way you're supposed to be. That sort of like pointing out the differences, pointing out how you're maybe considering yourself to be different. You're not so special. Well, you know what? According to Jewish tradition and according to most peoples, everybody's special. And it's those harsh voices when they cry out against anybody, any one of us, that's when we want to defend. But to stand up in that moment, to be an ally to yourself, to be an ally for another person, that means acting like Moshe and saying, "My ear is going to listen." Now that might be a hard thing to do, but in fact, being an ally for any issue, and especially for LGBTQ rights in the world today, means having the strength and commitment to a certain truth. Having the strength to be able to say, "Let me look at myself. Let me evaluate, am I doing things honorably? Am I fighting for justice? Am I going for equality?" And if we can say, "I'm doing the best that I can and I'm doing goodness according to what I understand to be that way that we're supposed to, honor, creation." Well then, if I'm doing all those things, then I should have trust in the people around me. What I think happens so much is right now we're evaluating each other and judging so much based on not being curious and not having the ability to really look within other people. Where are their ideas coming from? And it's a very, you know, prickly environment for us to live in. But an ally will commit to clarity and to self-knowledge and to doing something which, you know, there are recommendations. There's so many wonderful websites out there, but GLAAD, which is the Gay and Lesbian Alliance Against Defamation, gives us 10 ways to be a good ally and friend. And among them, including being a good listener, being open-minded, willing to talk, inclusive, not assuming that everyone around you is straight, you know, not letting LGBT, anti-LGBT comments and phrases actually happen, saying, "It's not okay that you're saying that," Being a good ally, though, one of the important things for me that I try so much to embody, and I'm always struggling with this in my own life, but to confront my own prejudices and biases, even if it's uncomfortable, even if it's an uncomfortable thing to look in the mirror, the only way you can be an ally is to say, well, where do I come up short? How am I not understanding? Where do I need to learn? What's my growth curve? Instead of just, you know, deciding to lob criticism at other people, being an ally really, really, truly means looking in the mirror. What are my own biases and what are my own prejudices? Moses is able to take that step back. David is able to take that step back and actually come into a place where they make room for other voices to come in, to open themselves up, and to being committed to being a leader by example and having the ability to be a self-critic and having the ability to create tents around other people. That insecure comment may come from an entire lifetime of people hearing just incorrect information, making false assumptions about others. We can correct that, but we gotta make space. We gotta make space for that to happen. So that silence can make that space. Saying that is not okay to somebody, those beautiful words, that's not okay, also creates space for a conversation. It doesn't have to halt it in its tracks. So we have opportunities this Pride. And I invite you to think of how you're gonna help build shelters of peace around people. Who is it in your life who needs that right now? Is it somebody from the LGBTQ community? Is it somebody from the Black community? Trans women of color in particular now, right now, are experiencing huge, huge amounts of violence in our world. How do we build a tent around trans women of color? How do we make room for those voices that just have not been able to be heard because they weren't let into that tent of peace? We create that together. Our Hashkivenu prayer helps us mindfully and musically bring this to bear. And we sing that with the cantor.
Shkoach. Spread. And we come together as we sing our Vishamru prayer. Vishamru b'nei Yisrael.
As we're able, taking some time as we sing as a congregation, and then we'll go into just a few minutes of quiet contemplation, the Amida.
Adonai sifatai tivtach ufi yagita hilatecha. Adonai, open up my lips, that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu, Velohe Avotenu Vimotenu, Elohe Avraham, Elohe Yitzchak, Velohe Yaakov, Elohe Sara, Elohe Rivka, Elohe Rachel, Velohe Leah. Ha'el ha'gadol ha'gibor ve'hanora el elyon gomel chasadim tovim ve'kone ha'kol ve'zocher chasdei avot ve'imahot u'mevi ge'ula livnei v'nehem lama'an shemo be'ahava melech ozer u'moshia u'magen. Baruch atah Adonai magen Avraham ve'zrat Sarah. Ata gibor le'olam Adonai mechaye hakol, ata rav lehoshia morid hatal. Mechalkel chayim bechesed, mechaye hakol berachamim rabim, somech noflim verofe cholim, umatir asurim, umekaye memunato lishene afar, michamocha ba'al givurot, umidome lach, melech memit, umechaye umatzmiach yeshua, ונאמנת להחיות הכל. ברוך אתה אדוני מחיי הכל. אתה קדוש ושמך קדוש, וקדושים בכל יום יהללו חסלה. ברוך אתה אדוני האל הקדוש.
Few minutes to reflect on your week, how you arrive at and embrace this moment of peace.
only me beside you. Still, you're not alone. No one is alone. Truly, no one is alone. Sometimes people leave you halfway through the wood. Others may deceive you. You decide what's good. You decide alone. But no one is alone. People make mistakes. Fathers, mothers, people make mistakes. Holding to their own, thinking they're alone. Honor their mistakes. Everybody makes one another's terrible mistakes. Witches can be right. Giants can be good. You decide what's right. You decide what's good. Just remember, someone is on your side, someone else is not. While you're seeing our side, maybe you forgot they are not alone. No one is alone. Hard to see the light. Don't let it go. Things will turn out right now. We can make it so. Someone is on your side. No one is Rabbi, Rabbi, you're on mute, so let's hear your prayers out loud. Oh, wait.
I thank you, Cantor, for that beautiful rendition. Thank you. And this week, there are so very, very many people who are sick, verging on countless friends, and the world is experiencing such a very dire situation. So we have to use our energy and the power of prayer to send out our prayer to other people in this moment for their refuata nefesh, their healing of soul, refuata guf, and the healing of body. In our congregation, in our small orbit, we're thinking of the following people, and please add the names of people for whom you are wishing healing right now to the chat box. Shraga ben Alexander, Yantafega bat Rachel, Eliyahu ben Sara, Harav Reuven Shlomo ben Mendel Velea, Naomi bat Miriam veHarav Yosef, Gittel bat Yehuda veChaya, Zisselchana bat Yitta Rivka, Levia bat Rachel, Gabriela bat Nechemia Udevora, Norma Agronoff, Bob Aronson, Jim Connolly, Pat Cottle, Lily Kovitz, Isabel Fazon, Ellie Guinness, Michael Gokenauer, Keith Hargrove, Keisha Hutchins, David Jenkins, Ethan Kadish, Ruth Kahn, Del McKillinger. We're thinking about Lachman Konar, Wilhelm Bill Lang, Todd Margulies, Mark Margulies, Nancy Martin, Linda Mendel, William Nolan, Anthony Panath, Clark Patton, Helene Piselnik, Cassie Rusch, Joe Sanders, Lisa Scher, Ben Simon, Doug Stossel, Florence Taylor, Annette Turner, Barry Turner, Sandy Tizer, Fran Ziegler, and Stan Ziegler. In addition to all of those whose names you mentioned in all of those who are. Every one of those people with total health and healing. We missed one name, Jack and Barb Goldberg's granddaughter, Ellie Schneider. Wish her much, much healing. And a prayer for caregivers, the heroes without capes. For all who are faithfully taking care of the community's need, may God reward them, protect them from, and remove from them all sickness and heal them completely. May God send them blessings and success in all they do, together with all of humanity, and let us say amen.
Amen.
And a prayer for our country. Our God and God of our ancestors, we ask your blessings for our country, for its government, for its leaders and advisors, and for all who exercise just and rightful authority. Teach them the insights of your Torah, that they may administer all affairs of state fairly, that peace and security, happiness and prosperity, justice and freedom may forever abide in our midst. Creator of all flesh, bless the inhabitants of our country with your spirit. May citizens of all races and creeds forge a common bond in true harmony to banish hatred and bigotry and to safeguard the ideals and free institutions that are the pride and glory of our country. May this land under your providence be an influence for good throughout the world, uniting all people in peace and freedom and helping them to fulfill the vision of your prophet. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they experience war anymore. And we say, amen. Amen. And for Israel, this blessing, rock and champion of Israel, please bless the state of Israel, first fruit of the flourishing of our redemption. Guard it in the abundance of your loves, spread over it the shelter of your peace. Send forth your light and truth to those who lead and judge it, and to those who hold elective office. Establish in them, through your presence, wise counsel that they may walk in the way of justice and freedom and integrity. Strengthen the hands of those who guard our holy land. Let them inherit salvation and life, and give peace to the land and perpetual joy to its inhabitants. Appoint for a blessing all our kindred of the house of Israel in all the lands of their dispersion. Plant in their hearts a love of Zion.
Avinu, Avinu, Sheba Shamayim, Tzu Yisrael Vegoalo. Avinu, Avinu, Sheba Shamayim, Tzu Yisrael Vegoalo.
The Aleinu prayer. We're going to stand for mentions letaken olam b'malchut Shaddai, that this is our job, to repair a world under the yoke of something much higher and bigger than we are. But God, implant in us that seed of courage to do your work. Aleinu.
Aleinu l'shabeach la'adon hakol la'tet gedula liyotzer bereshit shelo asanu kegoye ha'aratzot ve'lo samanu k'mishpachot adama shelo sam chelkenu kahem ve'gor aleinu kechol hamonam va'anachnu korim u'mishtachavim u'modim lifnei melech malchei hamlachim hakadosh Baruch Hu, Ve'ne'emar, Ve'haya Adonai, Le'melech al kol ha'aretz, Ba'yom ha'hu, Ba'yom ha'hu, Yihyeh Adonai echad, U'shemo, U'shemo, U'shemo echad.
Taking our seats, we think about people who have died in our lives and who are so dear to us, and they feel close to us whenever we say Kaddish. So tonight we are remembering in our congregation, we don't know of anyone who has passed away in the past, 7 days. We do have a name, I'll get it in a moment, I'm so sorry. The period of Shloshim, the 30 days, Iris Levy, Jerry Ryan, Deborah Behrens Tritt, Doris Krasick, Phyllis Rakoff, and Frances Kreiselman. When you hear the name of your loved one, you can stand up and remember them. We're remembering and acknowledging the recent passing of Congregant Susan Lifter. If you're joining us during the 11-month period after having lost somebody that you love, please stand up so we can acknowledge you. And if you want to, you can write their name in the chat box so we have their names in front of us. And this is the yard site, the anniversary for the deaths of Abraham Behrens, Nathan S. Berkowitz, Sylvia Bogner, Alvin Barak, Norman Cohen, Rose L. Cooper, Max David Fried, Gerald Melvin Friedman, Doris Harder, Jack Jaffe, Pauline Gitman Kahn, Alta Kravitz, Mildred Malinger, Steve Marcus, Minnie Marinoff, Michael McKee, Ruth Schumann Mendel, Mildred Nash, Jerry Office, Betty Packer, Melvin Rakoff, Scott C. Reed, Lillian Shanman Rose, we're remembering Newman W. Roseberry, Henry Ross, Isidore Schmerler, Mary Silverman, B. Lee Skulkin, Herbert B. Swartz, Gloria Traeger, Lillian Union, Alex Weinberg, and Patricia Zimmerman. Are there any additional names that you would like to add to this list, somebody that you love? We're remembering all of them as we stand for the words of Kaddish in front of you and within your hearts, we say together, Yitzgadal v'yitzgadash shamei rabba.
Amen.
Ve'oma divrach yiritei v'yamlich malchutei, v'chayechon v'yomechon v'chayei techol beit Yisrael, v'agala uvizman kariv v'yimru amen. Yehei shamei rabba mevorach le'olam ulalmei olmaya. Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitba'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase v'yitadar v'yitale v'yithalal shmei d'kudsha b'richu. Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata tush v'chata v'nechemata damiran bi'olma v'imru amen yeheshlama rabba min shemaya v'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Ose shalom b'imromav hu ya'ase shalom Aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'al kol Yoshvei Tevel v'imru amen. O God, strengthen those hearts who are grieving, comfort those who are wounded from losing the people in their lives that they've loved and lost. Take into consideration all of those whom we hold dear, and let us say amen.
Amen.
You can be seated. I think we need another slide before this. a little, there is a lot of fun in the summer, but it takes a little moving into. We have so many great opportunities coming up that we just want to tell you about. So incredible programming virtually for kids. And I think that our yoga and movement with Coach Heather, who's a member of our congregation, got so many likes on YouTube, or views on YouTube and likes on Facebook. It was awesome. And we have these other great specialists, art specialists, that your kids can learn with, your grandkids can learn with. You can come if you would like to. And we also have a whole community that we're calling the Temple Israel Wellness Community, which accounts for the fact that we all need sort of a place to park our vehicle, this body, this mind, this soul, which is maybe going a little bit on overdrive these days. I'm just saying, maybe that's just me, but you deserve a place to park, a good parking spot. So Jewish meditation, Musar, urban Zen, living like tall pines. We have great creative programming and a place to rest your mind and soul and maybe regroup, which we all need. So I hope that you'll also be sure to be watching out for, maybe like hoping that we can gather sooner than later. For Pride Shabbat sometime in the future, we've been blessed to have the Scheinman family and the Arndt family blessing us with Pride Shabbat celebrations for many years now. And it feels a little bit like half, because we're usually used to being together and like having a full-on gala. But we'll work our way up to that. And in the meantime, we know that you will continue to be that ally and refining who we are as a community so that we can be even better than we are and really make all of our colors just shine. So Shabbat Shalom, we're gonna make a little kiddush and motzi. Take it away, my friend, the cantor.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kitchanu b'mitzvotav v'ratzavanu, v'shabbat kodesho be'ahava v'ratzon hinchilanu, zikaron l'maaseh v'reishit, ki yom techila lemikra hekodesh, zecher letziat mitzrayim, ki vanu vacharta veotanu kidashta, mikol ha'amim, veshabbat kodshecha be'ahava uvratzon, hinchaltanu. Baruch atah Adonai mekadesh ha-shabbat. L'chaim.
Chaim. I have just one more thing. Can I use the chat box for one more thing?
Yes.
I feel like, we can't have people in our homes for Shabbos necessarily, but maybe just, you know, before we come and we break out and we wish each other a Shabbat Shalom in a minute, maybe just add one more thing. Just one person you'd love to have come to your Shabbat table. It could be Moses. I don't care who it is. But just one person. Maybe there's, you know, maybe Harvey Milk comes to mind. Maybe some great, you know, person who represents that movement that's made a difference in your life, or that person whose impression is just on your soul. Invite them to your Shabbos table by writing it in the chat box, and hamotzi.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, ha-motzi lechem min ha-aretz. Amen. La 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 la.